In this section, we want to talk about understanding data. We want to talk a little bit about what data is, what is statistics, what does it have to do with data, how do we collect and report data, and different types of data that we can collect and investigate. So let's start by talking about what exactly we mean when we talk about statistics. What is this field about? What do we cover? What do we study? So, if we want to be very general, we can break stats into two separate steps. The first step would be collecting data, and the second step would be doing something with that data. So, these are two very, very general steps. There's a lot involved in each of those, but statistics is basically concerned with going out and collecting data on something that we want to measure or better understand. That could be the amount of money people are spending, that could be the heights of people, that could be average birth weights, number of people who are affected by some particular disease, it could be future salaries for a career you're looking to go into. So we collect data on that topic that we're interested in, and then we do something with that data. In this class, we're going to be focusing on that idea of doing something with it. So we're going to have situations where data has already been collected, and we want to look at what questions we can answer now that we have this data. So we're going to be looking at how can we represent data, how can we visualize it, how can we make sense of it, and what questions or claims can we try to answer or support. A different way to think about statistics is to refer to it as data with context. So data on its own is just a bunch of numbers. A bunch of numbers don't mean anything until we start applying some context to it or recognize that those numbers have meaning in the context that they came from. So understanding the context of data is going to be a critical component throughout this course. With each new problem that we encounter, we're going to have three different components that we'll consider. So, unlike some math classes where you have a problem, you solve, and you get a number, and that's the end, in this class we're going to be doing much more than that. We're going to start off by verifying that we're using the correct approach. So, we're going to start off by verifying that certain conditions are met, checking that the data that we have meets certain assumptions, and justifying that the approach that we're going to use to tackle a problem is the correct one. Once we've got that numerical result or the graph that we're after, then we're going to look at interpreting that result in the context of the data. So if we were talking about something like averages, it won't be enough to say that the average is $532, or say that the average is 532. We'll want to say that the average is $532, and beyond that, what sort of thing are we looking at the average of? Are we looking at average person's average savings per month, a person's average spending on eating out or groceries per month? So everything that we talk about, we're going to talk about in the context of the problem, and whatever results we get, whatever context we put it in, we're going to look at communicating those results in a manner that's accessible and understandable to others. So these three steps essentially summarize what it is statisticians do. Assuming that collecting data step is already taken care of for us. Once we have data, statisticians look at verifying the correct approach to analyze or somehow present data. They interpret whatever results they come up with in the context of the data and communicate that information in a way that most people could understand, or people with at least a limited amount of statistical knowledge could understand. So that's what statistics is, but what you might still be wondering is, why do I need to take statistics? Or why do I need to learn this? So, I can be very honest with you and tell you that if you're taking this course, you're most likely not a math major. You're probably not on track to become a statistician. But taking statistics is a really great opportunity. There's a lot you can really pull away from this because we increasingly, more and more, live in a data-driven world. A world where decisions are being made based off data that's collected. When a company decides on a new product they should start producing, when they decide on an advertising campaign, how much money they should spend, where they should target that, what demographic they should target it to. If we talk about criminal justice, we're concerned with crime rates. Are they increasing, decreasing? Are there any patterns that we can recognize? If we're talking about healthcare, we're looking at similarly increases or decreases in emergency room treatments. For instance, maybe somebody's researching whether preventative care reduces the amount of time patients remain in a hospital for a given stay. There's always the question of salaries in a certain field. What's the average salary? So if you're looking to go into interior design or performing arts field, if you're looking to become an engineer or some sort of technician, what sort of lifetime earning can you look at? So statistics has applications in pretty much every field because so many decisions are based off data. So, specifically, we want you to understand this material because someday you may be called upon to analyze data in a future job. Even if you're never hired as a statistician, you're going to have an employer or boss at some point who might have data they've collected and need to try to make some sense of it. You may have to read some statistical report. And know whether or not the conclusions they're reaching are justified. Do they make sense? This would especially be true in a medical field. If a new treatment method, a new drug comes out, and they're making the claim that it's more effective at helping patients who use this treatment, are they correct? Are they leaping to conclusions without having evidence to support that? Should you recommend that for your patients? Or would that be a bad decision? And even if neither of those things happen, simply knowing that your life will be greatly affected by statistical analysis. So, one of the easiest examples to talk about here is something that you have no control over, but affects you, most people, every day, is how much you pay for car insurance or homeowners insurance or health insurance. Those numbers aren't arbitrarily decided upon. They don't just throw darts at a wall to see what they should charge you. There are all sorts of factors that they take into consideration. They collect data on current drivers, who gets into accidents, who doesn't get into accidents, how bad are those accidents, are there any certain indicators that make you more likely to get into an accident? Which is why certain genders have to pay more for insurance, or certain age groups have to pay more for insurance. There was a period in time where my insurance was cheaper because I lived within 10 miles of where I worked. That's no longer a consideration. They've collected more evidence and decided to pull that out of the equation. But even if you yourself never have to analyze any data in a job or read statistical reports, things that are happening around you in your life and directly affecting you are going to be the results of statistical analysis. So, this course will give you an idea of how some of those decisions are made and also equip you with the ability to make some of those decisions for yourself if that need arises.